Hello, everybody. My name is Richard Sherman.
And my name's Milt Larson. The album was originally called
Sing a Song of Sickness. And actually, it was the sequel to an original album that we had written a few years earlier called
Smash Flops.
And Smash Flops really was spawned by a song, a legit song, that my father, who was a wonderful songwriter, had written back in the 20s. And you were playing one of your collections.
Yes, I should probably tell the people that I'm a fanatic record collector. I collect recordings of show business personalities. And I've met Richard, going back to days when Dick and I were both very, very young. And we met each other through my interest in old phonograph records and his interest in old phonograph records, because he was collecting records of all the hit songs that his father made. Why don't you mention
exactly? Well, actually, Al Sherman wrote so many lovely big hits in the 30s and the 20s. Some of his biggest hits were "You Gotta Be a Football Hero" and "No, No, a Thousand Times No," "Potatoes Are Cheaper," "Now's the Time to Fall in Love." Great songs that were very, very popular then, and I was trying to collect some of his old recordings, and I wandered into an old rare record store, and there was this young fellow playing a Harry Richman record. It happened to be a song of my dad's. And I said, "What's a young fellow like you playing this ancient record for?" And you said...
Well, I said, I happened to be working for Ray Avery at the time, and instead of paying me in money, he paid me in phonograph records. I had this recording in my hand, and Dick Sherman is pulling the record out of my hand, and we're having kind of a tug of war. It's lucky the thing didn't break.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I said, "You know, why do you want this record?" And he said, "Because my father wrote the song." And I said, "Well, that's a good enough reason."
You invited me down to your collection in your home.
Yeah, I said, "If you like Al Sherman songs, I've got a whole big room full of recordings. I've probably got more than one." And it turned out I had dozens of them.
Actually, in that one little short meeting, we formed a friendship that's been God knows how many...
Well, it's been half a century or so.
Yes, it has been. The secret to good songs, no matter what they are, whether they're pure comedy songs, satires, no matter what they are, is the concept, the idea. And if you get a brilliant idea, a brilliant concept, you're three quarters of the way home, because it's always been three parts. If you got a great idea, then you set it to words and music. But without a great idea, it's just another song, and people will forget about it. And actually, Milty was playing this record of my father's called Lindbergh, Eagle of the USA. And it was a great tribute to that lone flyer who flew across the Atlantic. And I explained to Milt, after he played the record, "You know, that song was written while Lindy was still in the air."
And I said, "But what would have happened if Lindbergh hadn't made it? You know, they wrote the song, and they went to the publisher, and he said he's going to record it. Well, if Lindbergh had the misfortune to fall into the ocean and die, which would probably happen in the middle of the Atlantic, probably nobody would be interested in Lindbergh, the Eagle of the USA."
And that is how Smash Flops.
Yeah, we will write some songs about events that went slightly askew.
So we had songs such as Bon Voyage Titanic.
When the Hindenburg lands today.
Absolutely.
One of my favorites was Congratulations, Tom Dewey.
So our first successful album of comedy satire was Smash Flops, and then
our first hit was a flop.
We were pressed to write another series, and we decided to take a slightly different tack and talk about things that nobody talks about and say them in the most impolite possible way we could. And so we came up with the idea of Sing a Song of Sickness.
What goes around comes around.
Exactly.
And one of our songs, it was one of our classics in Sing a Song of Sickness, was Watch World War III
on pay TV.
And the amazing thing about that was that when we wrote it, the idea of a war, there could obviously never, ever be another war. And the other part was pay TV.
Whoever,
the networks were never going to let pay TV come in. Here is a song that would be so out of place and so
completely
wrong that it would be funny.
So we actually felt that there were so many of these things that really the bite is still in them, because we had, for example, the annual get-together of the KKK and NAACP.
That is really frightening.
We're waiting for it to happen still.
We have unlisted cars. It's fun to be hazed.
And, oh, yeah. Yes.
And just the headline the other day was a terrible thing about a hazing that took place in some college and the people were hurt. And so what goes around comes around.
There was this disgruntled fellow who was singing about send the girls over there. Now we have lots and lots of girls in the service under fire and doing all kinds of heroic things.
In the 60s, you'd never think of
sending
a girl.
You'd never dream of it.
Khaki and lace underwear.
Exactly. We had great fun with it, and we just truly hope that you will too.
Next time you're having a party and you want to get rid of your guests, you'll play some of these.
It clears the room every time.
I like that. That's fun.
Well, we can do that.
What the heck, you know? Why not?